Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm a product manager at Microsoft on the Windows Server, System Center, and Azure Data Center Solutions team focused on delivering more efficient data center solutions for customers to better manage their environment and deliver services to those customers, whether they be on premises or across varying cloud environments. So we've been talking about IT service management, and what does that mean within the service manager component, and how are we bringing together the ITIL V3 learnings into the product itself? I want to talk about the SLA insights and reporting. This is all about enabling IT to provide more intelligent reporting for better decisions, and that's something that we're going to do through a number of different mechanisms. So let's dive into what that looks like. We want to make sure that the decision makers, the technical decision makers, IT decision makers, have all of the necessary information at their fingertips to better make a decision around usage and performance or of the clouds that they've been assigned, or the information about the workloads or infrastructure costs. Trending and forecasting is a big one. And this is where they want to enable other business units or senior leadership beyond IT to make better decisions around the enterprise as a whole. We'll later talk about how we use OLA insights and reporting, or the operational information, for IT to make a better decision upon itself. But right now, let's talk about what this looks like for IT to hand out to other people to make better decisions. So we want to make sure that we have rich dashboards and reporting. So we use SharePoint to do that. We have integration with SharePoint now, as we've talked about in our automation and self-service piece. SharePoint integration. We're leveraging SharePoint pieces with Service Manager. We now can think about creating a rich dashboard to be able to do that, to bring together price sheet costs. We understand spending trends, understand cloud costs, as well as using Excel to deliver a dashboard as well, if you so choose. Many of our customers are very fluent in Excel and want to make sure that we still bring that asset together, bring that asset forward to be able to provide some of that similar information around cloud usage and cloud resources. So this is something that we want to make sure that we bring together, because when you put this in front of your decision makers, where they can easily see the trends and impact on their environment and on their financial demands, helps them to better make a decision to understand which is the best direction for them to go. So how do we do that? Our big feature that we want to talk about today is chargeback. And this is where we're bringing Service Manager in the Data Warehouse, Virtual Machine Manager, and Ops Manager together as a solution to help IT deploy and provision cloud resources and understand the cost impact and drive behavior as we move forward. So let's think about why chargeback is important and what does it do. Chargeback optimizes infrastructure usage. And how does it do it? It does it in three key areas that I want to talk about, that I want us to really pivot on, is driving the correct behavior and the management behavior within the enterprise. As we think about where environments are going in terms of cloud computing or data center management, we're now expanding across clouds. And in fact, the Microsoft Cloud OS is all about expanding that data center from on-premises to public cloud with Azure, or even service provider environments. But before we get there, before we leave our on-premises infrastructure, we need to make sure that we're thinking appropriately around how we do that. So we need to balance needs with resources. We want to ensure, what chargeback helps us do, is to ensure that we request what we need and that we've used what we requested. So we don't want to over-provision. We don't want to underutilize, because too many times we've seen environments and we've heard of customers provisioning resources and never using them again, because we've handed it off to someone, but perhaps that team never used it, or they've used it and they've been done with it, but IT didn't know that they could recapture that. Now we want to drive behavior that says, hey, I know I need to give some resources back. I've requested them. There's some cost associated with them. I'm on the hook for these resources. I need to give them back when I'm done. Because when you get to varying cloud models, costs vary across clouds. So you want to make sure that we're being mindful about what we're requesting, what we're using, because that's becoming a financial impact upon the enterprise, upon IT. The other thing that we want to do is think about the technical features. We want to think about, what does chargeback actually deliver? Well, what it delivers in R2 is monitoring usage, and it's allocation based, so that as you request a VM cloud or VM resources, that is, once they're allocated to you, once you request it, once we provision them, the timer starts ticking, and that's when your ticker starts to go in terms of what you're on the hook for in terms of a business unit or a tenant. We then have pricing models, or we have a pricing mechanism available to you through price sheets. And then we have the insights and reporting piece, which says we can now build reports based on that information and provide that back to those users, back to those departments as needed. Why is this important? Is because the business capabilities enables us to think about planning and insight, building out the correct infrastructure and not over-provisioning. I know what I need to procure. I know what I can retain or what I can get back from those users or those departments and reallocate elsewhere. I can then also build out the correct infrastructure as I need to, because that's what's going to be best for me to optimize those resources, whether it be storage, whether it be compute, VMs, etc. And I can provide that insight into the usage of those services. So now people can get more intelligent data around who's requesting what, when, where, and why. So let's talk about aligning chargeback capabilities to an organization. And we see this in about four different pieces. We have informal, where we're thinking about, we just want to provide some usage, some VM usage metering and reporting, no pricing, just basic information about what's out there in terms of resources. We have folks that want to get more technical in terms of no physical pricing in terms of, hey, I'm not actually getting money back, but I want to do some showback. Hey, I've identified what I think these costs are and want to apply that to that reporting and give that back. And we see that as a technical level. Then the business wants to do some basic pricing. They say, hey, I need to really get keen on tying a price to these resources and providing a usage-based or cost transfer mechanism as a next step. And that's where I get a bit more dynamic as I move up this scale. And customers, based on your environment, can have a mixture of these needs based on what you want to show. And then lastly is where I get a real formal chargeback mechanism, and where I think about this as integrating into my IT financial management system, or I call this in a billback scenario. I've gone from showback, I've gone to chargeback or showback, and then I can say a billback scenario is where now I'm going to actually transfer or recover those costs and impact our financial management system to ensure that we are getting what we're paying for that. And it requires a keen piece of data on accurate pricing and costing on both levels. So what do we deliver within the product? Within SP1, we saw this deliver within informal, technical, and the business case. But we also saw in R2 that we were able to expand out into a third-party connector if we want to do the formal finance mechanism piece, if you want to do that as well. So in R2, we're able to still deliver on the same things we delivered in SP1 and expand into that formal space if we need to as well. So let me walk through a process, and I think this will be good for us to visualize how this actually works and what are the connection points across the stack within System Center. Again, remember, the key pieces are Virtual Machine Manager, Operations Manager, and Service Manager. So we have a business user. It could be a developer. In this case, it's a developer. And they have a VM that they want to have access to, and the thing that we're measuring today is going to be storage, compute, and memory. In this particular case, we want to make sure that we are measuring this information appropriately, and we're getting this information from Virtual Machine Manager, because Virtual Machine Manager is where we have a lot of the components around usage, resources, and roles. And in fact, the concept of the tenant role being introduced into Virtual Machine Manager is where we brought this to life. So now the VM that resides in a cloud provisioned by a Virtual Machine Manager is where I'm getting this information. I dump this into Service Manager or the data warehouse. And I can, for instance, a user is actually going to go into the portal and request that service. They're going to say, hey, I need a virtual machine. And in our automation and self-service piece, we actually walk through a user doing this. And then that's where we apply some quotas. We apply some leases and approvals for this process. I then kick off my chargeback process, where I analyze that data, apply some price sheets that I've already predefined, and I generate those reports. Those reports get kicked out either Excel or SharePoint. I can build out a dashboard in SharePoint where I can get real-time access, or I can spin up some unique, customizable Excel spreadsheets if I need to as well, and get that information back to the admin or the infrastructure admin, data center admin, or I can give it back to that business user if I so choose. So that's everything that we've been able to do within the informal or the technical or the business scenario within System Center 2012 R2 out of the box today. Now, what about that last step, that formal step of actually doing that financial mechanism piece? And this is where we want to introduce a partner, and where we provide integration into some partner solutions, we have third-party connectors, where it could be a Cloud Cruise or an Aptio or someone of the like that actually connects into your financial management systems, provide some access through their web portal, and can provide those reports back to those same groups of people, whether it be the developer or the data center admin. So we've been able to deliver that in a number of different ways to be able to deliver that experience to customers. And that's the chargeback as a whole in the process that we'll walk through. Again, we're monitoring VM resources, and it's the storage, compute, and memory components that we're going to be tackling. If you want financial management, you want to actually exchange costs or exchange money between organizations, that's when we think about bringing in a partner to actually bring this story, extend that story even further. So just some basic house cleaning in terms of setting it up. You want to make sure that you have virtual machine manager set up and a console installed. You want to make sure that you're going to set up your data warehouse. You want to make sure that you create your clouds appropriately, and you want to make sure that we connect to those clouds across that are coming from virtual machine manager over into service manager. And these are those connectors that you'll see within service manager. And I'll take a look at what this looks like in a moment. And then you want to make sure that we're bringing in the correct information from operations manager, where we're getting that monitoring and that information correctly and brought into the data warehouse within service manager. Additionally, we want to make sure that we check and make sure that data warehouse is configured, is registered appropriately, and that we're also taking advantage of either Excel 2010 or even Excel 2013. We're compatible in both of those modules, and we want to make sure we import the chargeback management pack, which we have available as well. I'll show you this in a moment in terms of what this looks like. But when we do that, we then can start to bring in our price sheets, apply our prices to them, and then use a Microsoft toolset to be able to analyze that data for chargeback. So what does that process look like? I want to get that data where virtual machine manager is then brought in, and I want to make sure that I connect to operations manager and then the service manager data warehouse. That's me getting the data. That's how that data is going to flow between those different components so that I know who requested what, when, and where, and how much, and what is the specific VM. Who is the tenant, or what business unit were they attached to? I also want to make sure that I store this data. So I want to process that information and load it into the data warehouse via the data mart. And then I want to make that sure that that's available for me to access. And when I do that, I'm going to use OLAP cubes. And that's going to be OLAP cubes or even the SQL data marts. I can use that as well. And I can render that through SQL Server reporting services, SharePoint, or even Excel. And then ultimately render that through dashboards or through Excel. And that's how we're basically going to get those services in there. I can take a look at what this looks like here, and you'll notice I have a VM. This is kind of one of the price sheets that you'll see within the tool. But you'll have the price of the VM or the cloud membership. I have compute, I have memory. I have some additional options that I don't have to actually apply, but if I choose to, I can have a high availability cost. I can think about static IPs or an expanding of VHD per day, right? What is that cost for that per day? Then I want to bring in my clouds. I want to make sure my clouds are brought in and I've built that out appropriately. Now, when I build my chargeback reports, I want to make sure that after I access the data warehouse and I want to create these OLAP chargeback cubes, and I've already done this within my environment. I'm going to take a look at what some of those cubes are. I then want to look at my cloud costs or the VM costs, and I can create each one of those as items or dimensions of that cube so that they are predefined, and when I come into the price sheets, IT has set them, can set them appropriately. You then have several choices for the reporting mechanism, which we'll see, and here's one view that we'll look at in a little bit more detail in Excel, or we even have these in SharePoint, in which you'll need to make sure that you're using Performance Point to go in and access the Performance Point services as well as the SharePoint server publishing to ensure that we can publish this data, publish this information appropriately. And that will enable us to provide a real-time experience for our customers, or for your customers within your environment, I should say, excuse me. So let me go into Service Manager. I want to go take a look at this in real time and one of the environments that I have. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to look at where chargeback can be accessed within Service Manager and look at that basic report that we just saw. So I've signed in to into my VM where I have Service Manager. I have the Service Manager console set up, and I've installed Chargeback. I've already gone through this process and created and configured Chargeback. Now, when I'm here, I can also click down and see infrastructure. I'll see my clouds, and I have a number of clouds that are here that I've already created, and these are coming from Virtual Machine Manager. Real quick, if I click on connectors, what's enabling me to do this is pulling information from Virtual Machine Manager. And I'm making sure that I'm connected, that I'm talking to that particular component within the enterprise. And so I'm looking at the same clouds that I have that you see here as well. And so this is a big part of the integration story that we're talking about. Now, I have price sheets. I want to see, what are the price sheets that I have here? I've already created one, and I want to go in to look at what this price sheet looks like. When I go in, I'm going to name this price sheet. And when I do that, I need to make sure that I publish this price sheet first before you actually close this out and continue, because you want to make sure it's applied to the resources that are going to be requested, provisioned, and allocated within your environment. Okay. Now, pricing is where I actually add my pricing of these resources within the environment. I have a cloud membership price that I can add per day, or a VM price per day. I have my compute, my memory, and my storage of that VM per day, and that's what's going to be tied to that tenant or user. So I know who requests it and which call center is that tied to. So now I know, if I think about this in terms of IT delivering it to multiple business units, I know which department is on the hook for those resources that I've requested. Additional resources I mentioned, high availability, static IP, or expanding the VHD is additional information that I can start to capture for this particular resource. Now, assigned clouds is another one. I have a cloud that I've already assigned, and if you have your list of different varying clouds, you can select them from here when you go to add cloud and select them and add them to an environment. For instance, if I wanted to add an internal environment here, I would click OK, and I've done so. And then I can apply that, and I can just click OK. That's as simple as it is to create a price sheet for the cloud. The legwork at the outset is really ensuring that you've created all of your necessary clouds within Virtual Machine Manager, that you've connected to them, and that you're getting the connection here within Service Manager, and you're able to leverage those resources for chargeback itself. So another piece that we also talked about is within the data warehouse is where you have all your cubes. So while this is loading, what we expect to see here is a list of all the data cubes that we have for different tasks or objectives services that we're going to be delivering. And we should have a chargeback cube here that we've created, and you can look at all the attributes of that given cloud. So in this one here, we're seeing our cloud services cube. We're seeing a number of the service catalog cube as well, where I can get information, but the one that I care about is a service manager chargeback cube. And you see all of your dimensions and data that you can start to manipulate and measure and identify the cost for within this environment. Okay? And then you can analyze that cube within Excel. So now that I have my cube, I have my chargeback cube, I want to analyze this in Excel, and I want to process that cube. I've already done this already, and I already have a report that we've seen already in our previous ones, which looks like this, and I applied it to a dashboard that I've created. Here's the dashboard. I've been able to identify and create this interface that allows me to understand what are my top cost centers. Again, Virtual Machine Manager owns the tenant, and I brought in that information from the tenant and been able to tie a cost center to that person. So I know who uses that and which one is it tied to. I can then look at what are my top clouds. Like I can have a gold, bronze, silver cloud in terms of the quality of service that I'm going to be delivering. I can see which ones are having the most usage. Who are my top users or my top tenants? Which price sheets are being used most? The reason you have multiple price sheets, perhaps one team has a different price you're charging for the same usage of services, one price versus a team that may have a varying price. For instance, your developers or your testing team may use resources and they may have a lower price for that same resource versus the marketing team or the different deployment team that you may have within your environment. I can look at spending trends or overall spending. I then can break those out and look at those users. I can look at who are those users that I have in my environment and which assets are they utilizing most. Oh, excuse me here, clicked the wrong button. And I can see some information per day on the cores or the memory per days or the storage or the VHDs or the static IPs. That was a selection that I selected as well. I can see that information per cost center. Or I can even expand that out to a monthly view if I so choose. So this is how we actually bring in price sheets to apply to requests that are made within a self-service experience. And then we allocate those VMs, allocate those clouds, and then apply these price sheets to those clouds once we do that. So that's how we do that. Let's step back to some more information on how we actually leverage this to make better decisions within our environment. All right, so why traditional service management? And what does that mean? What do we mean when we say traditional service management? This is the approach to service management prior to where we are today, and what has driven a lot of the requests, the need, the demand in the environment. It's IT behavior, that physical infrastructure. We have SLAs in a matter of weeks or months, and we have capacity that needs to be managed by the consumer. Well, now we need to shift in terms of that consumer behavior in terms of ensuring that they're requesting what they need and using what they requested. Now we can provide, once we do that, now we have that service management approach to be able to have those pooled resources that can use a virtual infrastructure. So now I can swap resources upon need and upon usage. Once you're done, you give it back and I can continue moving forward. We have SLAs that we drill down in terms of hours and days now. And then we have capacity that's managed now by the service provider. Business units have given us their need. This is what they need to do in order to deliver a product or a solution or a service to their end customers. So we need to support them. And how we support them, we build out requirements and a structure within this virtualized infrastructure as a IT service provider. And that's what we can do. We can then plan on how we build out our infrastructure to meet those demands. We identify where our OPEX versus our CAPEX expenditures may be, or where our direct costs or indirect costs may lie. Once we do that, we now have a better mechanism to inform our enterprise decision makers on how we shift for the future. Now, from a governance perspective and proactive controls perspective, is where we're taking advantage of the integration that we've already talked about, we've been talking about with Service Manager and with Virtual Machine Manager, Operations Manager, because VMM holds that quota and those leases, those approvals, and all that information. And then we want to make sure that we provide showback. Is showback needed instead of chargeback, or do we need to show both? Do we need to bring in a service provider to take that additional step? So once we do that, we have deeper insights across multiple clouds, and it's not just what's on premises, but then we can expand into that next step of expanding clouds. So how do we do that? IT meeting the needs and saying, I need more information about what's consumed and what's provisioned in that external cloud. I'm taking the CMDB out of Service Manager. I'm looking at Orchestrator with all of the richness in the runbooks, as well as my self-service experience portals. And this is where I can build out the experiences within each of those. Once I do that, I can store that information and report on it, regardless of how they've requested it, because I've automatically provisioned it based on that self-service experience. And then I can deliver those rich reports and those dashboards for the decision makers as I need to. So once I do this, I'm using the service request and that service offerings and the request offerings as the mechanism in the back end within the portals to be able to do that. I'm using the automation components within Orchestrator to be able to drive the workflows of the system executions that need to occur. And then I'm using operations to monitor the status. And I can think about that in terms of health or usage or whatever the case may be. And then I store that information and I can report on it. And that's how I deliver that information back to, let's say, a development team to be able to make better decisions in terms of how they operate in their business. And I can identify which clouds and resources are best suited to be able to scale. When I do that, I'm taking advantage of that out-of-the-box experience for being able to seamlessly manage across those clouds and have those partner-enabled integration packs that helps me be able to take advantage of that solution as well. So to finish up here, I want to just think about a single view of the cloud service usage. It's all about IT decision makers being able to have the views that they need to make the best decisions and ensuring that they have the optimal resources available, delivering the best services, and taking advantage of the hardware innovations that may exist in the environment already. Those decisions can then reduce costs in terms of hardware that they procure or infrastructures that they spend up or infrastructure resources that they spend up and want to make sure that they're having the optimal provisioning solution that's out there for their end users to be able to leverage. So that sums up the gist of what we're delivering in terms of SLA insights and reporting and taking advantage of chargeback to be able to do that. But we want you to continue to follow on IT service management and a lot of the segments that we're going to be talking about moving forward in terms of those rich processes from ITIL or those internal views for OLA insights and reporting. But to continue on, we want you to get your hands on the product and go to the TechNet Download Center and download the products, System Center 2012 R2, and try out Service Manager. Start to play with it. Take the next step and go to TechNet Virtual Labs and try out some of the cool labs that we've created and the unique scenarios that you can do at your own pace whenever you want. And ultimately come back to Microsoft Virtual Academy and continue on our IT service management track and learn more about how System Center 2012 R2 with Service Manager delivers that. Also take advantage of the other System Center capabilities that we've been talking about as well. Again, this is Brandon Matherson. I thank you so much for your time, and please come back and join us soon.